Hello students. In my previous lecture, I had talked about the wireless ad hoc networks. What are their various types? What are their advantages and applications? In today's lecture, I'll be talking about the features of the wireless ad hoc networks. Look, regardless of the application, there are certain critical features that can determine the efficiency and the effectiveness of the wireless ad hoc networks. And these features are categorized into two types. One is the quantitative features and another is the qualitative features. Under quantitative features, we have various types of features. They include, number one, the network setting time. Now, network setting time is a time which is required for a collection of the mobile wireless nodes to automatically organize themselves and to transmit the first task reliably. So it is extremely important. This time is extremely important when a network has not been in operation for a while and then must start up and send the messages promptly. So it's a time which the network takes to settle itself. So next one is the network joining time. That's the time which is required for an entering node or group of nodes to become integrated into the ad hoc network. That means the time required to join the network. Third one is the network depart time. That's the time which is required by the ad hoc network to recognize the loss of one or more nodes and to recognize itself to route around the departed nodes. Fourth one is the network recovery time. Network recovery time is the time which is required for the network to recover after a condition. Like, there can be any kind of condition, especially, for example, for a collapsed portion of the network due to the traffic overload or due to the network failure to become functional again. Or it can be, the recovery time can be the time which is required for the network to reorganize because of the node mobility and resume the reliable communication again. Next, fifth one is the frequency of updates or overhead. Now, in a given period, a number of control packets or bytes or overhead bytes in a package are required to maintain the proper network operation. So that's the fifth feature. Next feature is the memory byte requirement. So that's the storage space which is required in bytes, including the space which is required for the routing tables and other management tables. Last feature, last quantitative feature is the network scalability. So that is the number of nodes that the ad hoc network can scale to and reliably preserve the communication. The wireless ad hoc network should be able to scale to a large number of nodes, let's say 1000 number of nodes. So this was about the quantitative feature. Next, I will be talking about the qualitative features of wireless ad hoc networks. Now, these include various kinds of quantitative ad hoc networks. First one is the knowledge of the nodal location. Now, that simply means that whether the network has the routing algorithm or does it require the local or the global knowledge of the network. Next one is the effect due to topology changes. It means that does the routing algorithm need complete restructuring or incremental update? Third one, adaptation to radio communication environment. In the previous lecture also, I had talked that wireless ad hoc network have a very dynamic topology as the nodes may be mobile. So the links may have to contend with the side effects of the radio communication like, you know, noise, fading and interference. So this feature is quite important, the meaning of this feature, adaptation to radio communication environment, means that do the nodes use estimation knowledge of all the environmental factor like fading, shadowing or multi-user interference on the links in the routing decisions. Fourth one is the power consciousness. It simply means that is the network power conscious? So does the network employ the routing mechanism that consider the remaining battery of a node? Next one is single or multi-channel. This feature this feature figures out that does the routing algorithm utilizes a separate control channel. So in some applications, multi-channel execution may make the network vulnerable. Next is bidirectional or unidirectional links. So it means that does the routing algorithm perform efficiently on the unidirectional links or not. Next is the preservation of the network security. So that means that does the routing algorithm uphold the fidelity of the network. So that means whether the network is able to maintain the fidelity of the information, which simply means that whatever we are sending, whether the same thing is being transmitted to the receiver node or not. Next is preservation of the network security, which means then next one is the quality of service, QoS, routing and handling of the priority messages. So it means that is the network capable of handling the priority messages or not. So in other words, does the routing algorithm support the priority messaging, and can the network send priority messages or voice messages even when it is overloaded with the routine traffic levels. Next quantitative feature is real-time voice services. It means that can the network support simultaneous real-time multicast voice while supporting the routine traffic loads. And the last feature is real-time video service. It means that can the nodes receive or transmit the video on demand while still supporting the traffic level and other routine services. Thank you. I hope the features of wireless ad hoc networks are clear to you now. Thank you.